The paradox of tolerance states that if a society is tolerant without limit, its ability to be tolerant is eventually seized or destroyed by the intolerant. The First Amendment states that Congress shall make no law abridging the freedom of speech or of the press. Which one of these two ideas represents where we are now as a culture? Frankfurt School adherent, former member of the Brain Trust of the OSS American War Machine, and godfather of the New Left, Herbert Marcuse, along with his contemporaries, engineered a slow-moving Marxist revolution from within American society, utilizing a mass psychoanalytic Hegelian dialectic psyop that is blossoming today amongst the lethargic minds of the millennial generation, a synthesizing technique known as repressive tolerance. Thankfully, in the interest of time, Marcuse simplified the definition of repressive tolerance, saying, "Repressive tolerance is intolerance against movements from the right and toleration of movements from the left. Repressive tolerance is achieved by arming the thoughts of emotional, rationally vacant liberals with the potent weapon of critical theory, a hive mentality that produces a catharsis for the self-loathing types of our society when confronting the social, historical, and ideological forces gluing the structures of a society together. Because congressional hearings are determining that American patriots are to be labeled white nationalists."
"And now we see witnesses invited by the minority who openly associate with purveyors of hate. White nationalism and its proliferation online have real consequences. Americans have died because of it."
"What about the man who's also really leading this for the White House, Stephen Miller? He is spearheading the immigration agenda, and Congresswoman Ilhan Omar actually referred to him as a white nationalist. Do you agree with her?"
"I believe that what we have seen from Stephen Miller is vestiges of white nationalism."
And now, a CBS show known as The Good Fight is leading a propagandized rehash of modern-day Bolshevism by legitimizing violence against anyone labeled a white nationalist by relabeling the paradox of tolerance as the Overton window.
"Is it all right to hit a Nazi unprovoked? I was always taught to never throw the first punch, never instigate. Defend, but don't attack. But then I saw a video of the white nationalist Richard Spencer being punched in the face during an interview, and I realized Spencer was in a press suit, wearing a tie, being interviewed like his opinion mattered, like he should be considered part of the conversation, like neo-Nazism was just one political point of view. And then I realized there's no better way to show some speech is not equal. Some speech requires a more visceral response. It's like Overton's window. That's the term from which ideas are tolerated in public discourse. Well, Overton's window doesn't mean unless it comes with some enforcement. So yeah, this is enforcement. It's time to punch a few Nazis."
This is a very dangerous precedent and should be dealt with immediately, as we tumble headlong into the fray of an impending presidential election, which the left will not accept, along with a record number of Democratic presidential candidates that agree with this Goebbels-level madness.
"Who are we?"
"You're African American.
That's your brand.
Diversity is in right now. We should be looking ahead to the future.
A future where Trump wins in 2020?
Televised mental illness that legitimizes attacking innocent, free-thinking Americans is now acceptable.
"Do you want a mission?"
"Do I want a mission?"
"I'm looking for people who are ready to take the fight to Trump."
They expect us all to accept their savvy, tongue-in-cheek, arrogant hypocrisy as relevant and cute to their demographic of anti-American far-left extremists and Antifa morons.
"I'm ready to fight. The resistance starts now."
"Do your worst."
"Oh, don't tempt me."
But they are literally calling for violence.
"So yeah, this is enforcement."
I am reporting this trailer to Twitter as a violation of their terms of service that state you may not make specific threats of violence or wish for the serious physical harm, death, or disease of an individual or group of people. John Bowne reporting.